We have seen application layer protocols like HTTP to access the web pages, SMTP to send an email, IMAP and POP3 to retrieve an email, FTP for file transfer. All such protocols send data to the next layer in the TCP/IP model called transport layer. Transport layer divides the data into smaller pieces and adds the header informations called segment. In every segment in the transport layer, the header information is added in a such a way you can achieve services like end-to-end connection between the hosts, reliable delivery, flow control, congestion control, addressing, and multiplexing. To understand all this functionality of transport layer, watch the video till the end. End-to-end connection. The transport layer is also responsible for creating the end-to-end connection between hosts, for which it mainly uses TCP and UDP. TCP is secure, connection-oriented, and reliable protocol. On the other hand, UDP is connectionless and unreliable protocol, which ensures best effort delivery. Reliable delivery. Transport layer achieves the reliability in terms of error control, sequence control, loss control, and duplication control. Error control means transport layer checks for errors in the messages coming from application layer by using error detection code, computing checksums. It checks whether the received data is not corrupted and uses acknowledgement and negative acknowledgement to inform the sender if the data has arrived or not, and checks for the correctness of data. Sequence control ensures at the receiver end, various segments of the transmissions can be correctly reassembled in the original order. Loss control is taking care of lost segments. Transport layer identifies the lost segment at receiver based on sequence number. And duplication control guarantees that no duplicate data arrive at the receiver. It allows the receiver to identify and discard duplicate segments. Flow control. If your sender is fast and receiver is slow, then the receiver discards the packets and asking for the retransmission of packets. This increases network congestion and thus reducing the system performance. The transport layer is responsible for flow control. It uses the sliding window protocol that makes the data transmission more efficient, as well as it controls the flow of data by informing the size of data it can receive. Congestion control. Congestion is situations in which too many sources over a network attempt to send data and the router buffers start overflowing, due to which loss of packets occur. As a result of retransmissions of packets from the sources increases the congestion further. In this situation, the transport layer provides congestion control in different ways. TCP provides AIMD, additive increase, multiplicative decrease, and leaky bucket technique for congestion control. addressing. When the segment arrives to destination host, it may possible that the host running multiple processes. Therefore, transport layer provide 16-bit user address, which is called port. Based on the destination port number in transport layer header, the data are transferred to the correct process. Multiplexing. Multiplexing allows simultaneous use of different applications over a network which is running on a host. The transport layer provides this mechanism which enables use to send packet streams over various applications simultaneously over a network. The transport layer accepts these packets from different processes, differentiated by their port numbers, and passes them to the network layer after adding proper header. Similarly, demultiplexing is required at the receiver side to obtain the data coming from various processes. Transport receives the segments of data from the network layer and delivers it to the appropriate process running on the receiver's machine. In the upcoming video, we will learn more about transport layer protocols with animated examples. Till then, bye-bye. If you like this video, press like and subscribe the channel and share the video. And don't forget to press the bell icon for my new video notifications. Thanks for watching.